Welcome to News Click. This is Janaki. Now let's have a look at the current Tamil Nadu political scenario. There's a lot of anger among people against the current ruling All India Anna Dravida Munnetra Kalagam AIADMK at the state and the BJP government at the center. People are fed up with the policy paralysis of the Modi government and the inefficient leadership of EPS and OPS combined. According to the latest trend from the ground, Dravida Munnetra Kalagam, DMK, in alliance with Congress, is likely to get more than 30 seats out of 39 in Tamil Nadu, whereas ADMK-aligned BJP may end up with 0 seats. The state is going for a single-phase polling on April 18th. AIADMK and DMK are the dominant Dravidian parties competing with each other in the state. They are contesting in a major election for the first time after the demise of their top leaders, Jayalalitha and M. Karunanidhi, respectively. Both the parties are contesting only in 20 seats and have left the remaining for the alliance. Interestingly, AIADMK and DMK will be facing each other only in 8 seats. Congress has more presence than BJP in the state. Patali Makkal Katchi, PMK, a major political outfit among the other smaller parties in Tamil Nadu, is contesting in 7 seats. It is the largest caste-based party in the state. The party has considerable support in the northern districts, especially among the Vanyar community, which has the concentrated vote share of 5-6%. But the party opposed ADMK strongly till the recent times, facing the credibility questions. Actor Vijayakanth-led Desiya Murpokka Dravida Kalagam, DMDK, is contesting in 4 seats. They allied with ADMK when DMK did not pay proper consideration. They were the principal opposition in 2011-16 assembly period, surpassing the DMK. But they have gradually lost their influence and have been forced to join the ADMK alliance this time, as their leader Vijayakanth have been inactive due to health issues. Tamil Manila Congress TMC, Pudhiya Tamilagam PT, New Justice Party NJP and All India NR Congress AINRC have got 1 seat each. Actor Sarat Kumar's Samatva Makkal Katchi has offered their support to ADMK without any seats. Communist Party of India, Marxist, CPIM, Communist Party of India, CPI, and Vidudalai Sirithaigal Katchi, VCK, have got 2 seats each from the DMK front. The popular figure Vaikos Marumalarchi Dravida Munnetra Kalagam, MDMK, is another prominent party in this alliance. But they are contesting in DMK's symbol. Indian Union Muslim League, IUML, Konganada Makkal Desiya Katchi, KMDK, and India Jananayaga Katchi, IJK, are the other parties coming in this line. All of them have 1 seat each. Though they have a key role to play in their belt, they are contesting in DMK's symbol, except IUML. All the small parties together had secured 30% of the votes in 2014 election, but now the political atmosphere has changed drastically. Many of them are not contesting in their own symbol. The distracted fraction of TTV Dinakaran's Amma Makkal Munnetra Kalagam AMMK from AIADMK and Kamal Hassan's fresh entry with Makkal Nidhi Mayam MNM are isolated. AMMK and MNM are contesting in all the constituencies. Though there is a less probability of winning any seat, AMMK can prove costly, especially to the ruling dispensation, the AIADMK, by cutting into their traditional vote share. Nam Tamilar Katchi, NTK, a Tamil nationalist party, contest in all the 39 parliamentary seats alone with a 50-50 gender representation. It had secured just over 1% of the total votes in the last assembly polls. But the experts say that the party will increase its vote share in this general election for various reasons, such as the inability of the state to resist unpopular central governmental schemes, anti-Dravidian mood among a section of youth and its improved cadre building. This is all about the current Tamil Nadu political scenario. Thanks for watching NewsClick.